Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're in North Central Washington on Banks Reservoir for wintertime walleye, and then we'll head to Flaming Gorge for some of those fantastic kokanee. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. This afternoon we're on Banks Lake, a beautiful offshoot of the Upper Columbia River, well known for its quality walleye fishing. We're with JRod Rodrigues and his daughter Haley, being guided by a well-known local angler, Eric Braaten. We're in a shallow bay off the main lake that fills with schools of baitfish in winter, making it a perfect place to vertical jig for walleye.
Which one Eric wants to let me use? Well, I have a color. I want to use the blue and the silver and the blue quarter ounce.
Okay.
Have it.
Yeah, that's a good color. Yeah. We have some kokanee in the lake. I got some pre-rigged up in here, some different colors at work. The fire tiger's been good in this glow, and I'm gonna give him this. You want a quarter ounce?
Yes, please.
And that's just kind of rigged with two trebles. And what's really cool on this bait fish is you see how thin it is on the top here, and it's a little heavier on this. And when you, it's kind of canters different when you pull from the middle pull point. And it actually has a really good vibration. And that's what sets this bait apart from other blade baits. The blade baits that you have a weight in the front and they kind of angle down. And when you pull them, you're vibrating a little different. This one has a more even vibration right here.
So straight out the package, the Sonic Baitfish, they have multiple attachment points where you could troll them, cast them. And like Eric was saying, today we're gonna just attach it from the middle attachment point and we're gonna fish them sort of like a blade bait. And it'll be a vertical presentation. So once Eric says it's okay to drop, open your bail and get that lure down to the bottom.
I'm just gonna hit the anchor lock on the Minn Kota once I figure out, and then we don't have to worry about staying on the spot and then we can just fish. It's kind of a nice feature on these Tarovas. Especially with this light wind we got, it'll hold us in place for the most part. All right, I think we're close. We'll put anchor lock on. We can go straight down.
Okay, Haley.
This one's been beat up. Last couple weeks, the paint's come off. This is a quarter ounce fire tiger and it's been working really good. It's kind of my lucky one, so we'll try it. I'm using a 6'6" rod and I got some braid, and the braid lets me feel that vibration of the bait. And these bait fishes, they have that little ridge like I was saying, and when it vibrates, you can really feel it. So I go all the way to the bottom and then I try to stay as vertical as I can. And then usually with these quarter ounces, it takes a while for it to get to the bottom. But there, I just hit the bottom. And so then I reel down and I can feel the bottom there. And then I'm just popping the rod and I'm waiting for that tap. And usually these fish, they think it's an injured minnow. And you can see on the fish finder there, I'm on the bottom and you can see the bait fish working. And so now that vibration actually sends out signals and these fish will actually come in from the surrounding area. And we should get a pop. And when you feel it, it's unlike anything else. It's just kind of like a tap and you have to kind of react and set the hook. So once in a while they're right on and you can really feel them.
And just like Eric was mentioning, you gotta feel the bottom, and you want to keep your tip low. That way, you have that much more room to possibly set the hook. If you're jigging up here and this far off the water, then now you gotta go even higher to set the hook. So we'll let that Sonic Baitfish get back down to the bottom. You'll see my line stop just like that, right there. Point your tip towards the water and just try to dial in your jigging style. There's a, there's lots of different styles of jigging. Eric's taught me on this one. He kind of, he'll go with the one pop, follow it down, then he'll give it another two, follow it down, and then sometimes he'll mix it up and just give it like a long one in there, just to kind of mix it up. The fish are pretty much going to tell us how they're going to want it.
I switched to a little silver one. Just taking it nice and easy. We're at 45, so if you just slowly bring them up, then they don't, they're not so distended. Thank you. Popped right out.
Back to Banks Lake, I'm Justin Wolf. We're with Eric Braaten, along with JRod Rodrigues and Haley, jigging big winter walleye by matching the hatch with sonic baitfish.
Thank you. Popped right up.
Oh, she's gonna go 20, 25.
Yeah.
24, 25 inches.
Beautiful fish, huh? From Banks Lake. This is like a probably a 22. I'm guessing I can measure it right here.
This looks like 24. Yep, 24.
24. Yep. We're just gonna release her. Very full of eggs. There she goes. And catch another one.
Really? Reel her in. That's a whitefish, is that what? Oh, scoop them in, yep.
That's a big whitefish.
Dang, that's a pretty fish. These,
we have a huge population of them.
Do they fillet?
Yeah, if you want to try to eat one.
I do.
They're a little bony. But this is kind of a small one.
Oh, they get bigger than that?
Oh yeah, I've seen them up to 8 pounds in a sleek. I think there'll be a state record coming out of this lake. That's how many there
really?
Are. Yeah, it's a pretty popular sport up here on Banks. I mean, they got a lot of people fish for them.
What do you want to
do? I think you can get 25 a day. You want 25 of these?
You want to keep it or you want to let it go? Haley wants to let it go.
She wants to let it go?
Yeah.
You want to let it go yourself? No, it's really nice. 80% of the fish in Banks Lake is primarily whitefish, lake whitefish. There's just a huge population of them. And they compete with the Kokanee.
Alrighty, so Eric got sent it up over there. He's got trophy walleye on, and today we have a garlic night crawler. We're gonna hit him with that garlic just to give him that little extra kick so he could stay on longer. And it's pretty quite easy, the application. Just get it going and just give it a little smear right across the bottom. And that'll stay, that scent will stay on that lure for quite some time. So, there you go. Got it?
Can I drop?
Yep, you drop it. Nice and slow. Just like that, Haley. Nice and slow. Do you see your face, Haley?
Good job.
Does it lean? Oh, it's a Wally.
Nice.
Good job, Haley. There you go. Put her back. She went. Good job, Haley.
Yes, I have goo all over my hands.
You have goo all over your hands? No, on the gloves, so you're fine.
So here's a perch that just came out of a walleye. And you can tell how the sonic, it's about the right size that we're using. So this at the quarter ounce and the half ounce. Here's a half ounce. And works perfect. Oh yeah.
There you go. Nice and easy. Right there. Nice and easy. Just like that. Okay, no. Keep your tip out. Nice and slow. Just like that. So keep reeling. Nice and slow. You got it. Just like that. Just like that. How does he feel?
He's happy.
He's going under the boat, so you put your tip out and hold him out.
Oh, that thing just inhaled that lure.
There you go. With some slack out. Open the bill.
It's hard to do with flat gloves.
Good job.
Good job. Right.
Go ahead and release her, Mo.
Toss.
Yeah, it'll go.
Good job right to the bottom.
Yep, as that sun's going down, Eric just decided to move us, and as he was doing that, I left my lure and down on the bottom and kind of were just trolling it, and this thing just smacked it.
Oh, nice one. It's not a whitefish.
When you guys are out on your guys' body of water, it's always good to practice catch and release. We're gonna let this big girl go. Snap a quick photo, then let her go, nice and easy. There she goes.
Wonderful.
Welcome to Flaming Gorge Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. It's a beautiful summer day, and we're after Flaming Gorge's extra large Kokanee.
Yeah, we just launched out of buckboard. We're going to head back out. We've been out the last 2 days. As soon as we launch out of buckboard, we're going to hang a left on the main river here, head up, work some of the walls, and see if we can get into some fish again.
So Bob introduced me to this Walleye pop yesterday, which is actually a walleye lure. We redid it, put the hooks a little bit closer here, and we were hammering Kokanee on this yesterday. It's a walleye lure, essentially. We redone it for Kokanee, put the hooks a little bit closer, has a smile blade on the top, has a little tube here in the middle with the scent chamber. Pull this top bead out, you can put your Procure bait scents in there. So basically you have your attractant built into the lure there.
All right. So on here I have got doing the pink sling blade. Pink glow sling blade here, and then trailing it with the new diamond orange smile blade on the double whammy. We got it tipped with corn. I'm gonna send that one down and see if it'll work for us.
So here we're actually using our max scent flash on our downrigger ball, and then followed up by a ball troll. So what's cool about these is you can open up this here with these three clips. There's a scent pad inside. Squirt a little Procure on here. Snap it back in, and that scent's gonna leach through these little holes here on our scent flash as we're trolling. We're running a cha-cha here with a smile blade spinner right on the top, and then an orange sling blade here. This is probably one of my favorite sling blades here. This works back home in California at New Maloney's. That's our home lake, and it's been working really good the last couple days here at the gorge too. So we're gonna try it again. So we're gonna go back just about 50 feet. These fish aren't shy. Back home, we set back 80 to 100 feet, but here at the gorge, we've been doing anything from 25 to 50 feet back, and we're getting bit. So these fish aren't very shy. So we're using our Four Fins downrigger ball here with our Max Ball Troll. Actually has a little bit of extra attractant there with these flashers. So it has the ultra releases. These are kind of tricky. Folks have a problem with these sometimes. So what we usually do is we put a loop in the line here. You put the loop right behind this little ridge, okay? Hold your thumb on that and snap the line in. You'll hear it click. What's even more important is you pull that loop back over the ridge, so when the fish hits, it'll pop out. Yeah, so this Four Fins downrigger ball, as you can see, is pretty aerodynamic just by design. With these particular fins here, it tracks well. You don't have to use a really heavy weight. Just by the design, it's gonna troll pretty much straight down, so you don't have that blowback with some of the other downrigger balls. Oh, here we go. All right. First hit. This one's set at 20 feet. This is that orange cha-cha smile blade we were talking about a minute ago. Oh, hope he's still there. And he spit it. Well, we're going to corn this guy up and put him right back out again. Yeah, I'm a one piece. I normally just put one piece of corn on each hook. Some guys like to load this stuff up with corn, but the way this stuff is scented and it gives them a nice little target here on this hook, One's enough for me, but hey, whatever your preference is. Pretty simple. So I'm running 10 pound P line here, 10 pound CXX P line. That's what I use on all my trot rods. Some guys like to use lighter line. I use 10 pound. You get a little bit extra abrasion resistance with your downrigger clips. I mean, we're clipping all day long with these things. So 10 pound works best for me. If I'm making leaders, I'll probably bump that up to a 12, 10 or a 12. That's kind of the business end of things. So I use a little bit heavier line there, but on my reels, I'm just using 10 pound here. So we're resetting this one back down at 20 feet. We've been getting consistent bites over the last couple of days from the surface all the way down to 35 feet. So we're staggered right now, running anywhere from 20 feet to 30, 23, 28, just to see where these fish want to bite. But first bite of the day was at 20 feet. So we're going to put it right back down there. Got a little bit of action down there, about 30 feet.
About 30?
Yep.
He's ready now.
He's ready?
Yep.
All right.
Oh, quiet. Howdy was.
We'll let him play out for a second. Go in. All right. Nice fish. That's a pretty one. Orange has been our color once again.
Welcome back to Flaming Gorge Reservoir, where a little experimentation with color and depth has really paid off.
So that one was down at 40 feet, so we're going to move a couple more of these down a little bit. We've been marking fish anywhere from 25 down to 40 feet. So we have a couple shallow here, so we're going to send those down as well and see if we can get some more hookups.
Yep, so that one that we just caught was on our new scent flash. So we have our scent flash triangle on our downrigger ball troll, and then we have our rig behind that. And that last one came on that brand new scent flash. So it's throwing all that scent out in the water as it's spinning through there, and it's just helping attract them.
Yeah, we kind of was having a lot of luck with the orange yesterday, so we kind of started with it today. Got a few bites, but not really taken off. So we maybe add a different color and see if we can't create a strike by changing something different.
There you go, right there. Go for it. Nice one.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. Oh, nope, it's gone. Just batting 1,000 for getting stuff tangled up today, Jose.
Oh, you good?
I think you can get him with the net, though. Oh, he came on them.
There we
came
go. And, oh, that side. Reel up a little bit, please. There you go. You can walk this side.
Yeah, there we go. Same in.
There
perfect.
We go.
All right.
Good job. All right, we were just talking about that double whammy.
Yeah. So in that one, on top, we have the pink dodger. The other one, we had the orange and gold on the sling blade. So this one's a little bit different, a little bit pink and orange mix.
That's it. One on each hook, and we're gonna send it back out there. This one's been quite the lure today. Nope. Not quite. Okay. He's still not done. There he goes. All right, I'm going to step back. Hold on a second. And up.
Nope.
All right, he's not done. There he goes again.
Oh, wow.
Another one on. There's one on right there.
I just barely put that one out.
Yeah.
Grabbed it on the way down.
Yeah, must have.
All right, ready? All right, push it on.
No, he didn't. Came off.
Came off.
Dang it.
You know, it's funny. We were kind of joking about this the other day, but I rig my line sometimes with these smile blades. I'll put a smile blade up above my sling blade in my rig, and I'll run the smile blade all day. Does a couple things. One, it keeps the bead from going through the eye if somebody reels it up too far, but it just adds that little bit extra attractant. And we've been talking about it the last few days. It seems like the rods that have this little smile blade right up ahead are getting the most hit. So, you know, maybe a fluke, but I think it actually works. All right, Steve's got one on.
Woo-hoo.
Oh, nice.
Got a jumper. He's just not quite ready.
Yeah.
Oh,
almost. Come here, little bugger.
He's hiding behind the mower.
Yep, bring him up.
There it is.
Yet again, the cha-cha.
Cha-cha. We just really put that one back down.
This is actually a nicer fish.
That is a very nice fish.
So far, this has been our hot combination right here. The cha-cha with the orange sling blade, one of my favorites I talked about earlier. This has been the most consistent for the day. Fish are getting nicer, so a little bit bigger kokanee here. Good job, Steve. So we're going to pick up and move. We're going to head back towards buckboard. So we're going to put our rigs away here, popping on our little Leadermate minis. Actually pretty easy to use. Some folks are a little confused on how to use them, but I use it a particular way that works for me. I reel my dodger up to about this length where I can grab it. I stick it in from this side here. I like to go underneath the bottom. Some folks go over the top, but I like to go underneath the bottom of the leader mate and back over the line here. It just keeps everything a little bit tighter when you're traveling and they don't come loose as easily. So once you get that thing buttoned up, you just put your hook right here in the leader mate anywhere. Snug it up and put it in your rod holder. So now these blades won't be spinning as we're traveling to the next fishing line.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, there would be no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.